Thank God it is December again, December of 2018. What a blessing to see this time of the year. It is really a privilege to be alive. As we speak right now, there are some people who have not lived to witness this moment. There are some people who are struggling between life and death right now. There are some people who are longing even for oxygen, but God has given us the privilege to be able to, you know, speak, to be able to hear, to have a sound mind. So I say, I am grateful. He loved mankind so much. He loved the world, not leaving out anyone. Everyone. Those who believe, those who don't believe, those who are still to believe, God loves you. And that is why He gave us this great gift to send His one and only Son, perfect Son, Prince of Peace, King of Kings, the one who was, is, and is to come. Yet God sent Him into this world to come and live among men, to show the way, and to finally take upon Himself all the responsibilities that man had brought upon themselves, the curse, the shame, the whatever it was that was a burden on man. Son of God came so that all of this could change. Come to think of it, as parents, think about how much you love your children. Me, as an example, I don't think I can give up my child. Even see today some parents, even when their children are the most hardened criminal, we still see the law, we still see how they fight for them, to keep them, not to give them up. And yet God gave His only Son, who was perfect, without sin, who was a king, to come and die for a common man like me and myself. What a gift. Christ came for us, and Christ is the greatest gift that mankind ever had. A friend who sticks closer than a brother. A friend who is always there for you. A friend who is interceding for you, praying for you at all times. So we thank God for a great master, a great teacher, a great friend, a great brother, because He says we are joined heirs with that one that you can turn to at any time, and He will never say. So which means when you open your heart, He gives you that grace to live for Him. He just did not love the world, but He so loved the world, which means He went to this extent to give us His only begotten Son. Whoever believes in Him, whoever believes in the fact that He came to die for you and my sins, will not perish, but will have everlasting life. There is someone somewhere who is struggling through life and don't even understand their purpose, who don't even understand why they had to live, where they came from, where they are going. They are just struggling through life. And no one has ever brought them this truth. Think of those who don't know yet about Christ and extend this love to them, because that is our mission on earth. Glory to God. This is Isabel Wara bringing you greetings from Kabod Outreach with love. Thank God it is December again, December of 2018. What a blessing to see this time of the year. God has brought us all through from January all the way to December. And, you know, We have just been counting our blessings because it is really a privilege to be alive. As we speak right now, there are some people who have not lived to witness this moment. There are some people who are struggling between life and death right now. There are some people who are longing even for oxygen, but God has given us the privilege to be able to, you know, speak, to be able to hear, to have a sound mind. So I say, I am grateful. And I just want us to discuss about being grateful and, you know, talking about the greatest gift that mankind ever received. So the title of our message today is God's greatest gift. And that is Him sending His one and only begotten Son to die for us so that we can be reconciled with Him. So before we start, as always, I would want us to bow down our hearts in prayer, please. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you. We just give you all the glory and all the praise because you are our God. Father, we know that it is not by our might. It has not been by our strength. It has not been by any of our efforts, oh Father, but it has been all by your grace. So we give you the glory. Father, we pray and we commit this session into your hand, oh God. We say, be the Lord over this broadcast. Be the Lord over everything that concerns the word that will go forth in Jesus' mighty name. Father, follow this with your power so that our lives may never be the same. Father, we give you all the glory and we say thank you. In Jesus' name we've prayed, amen. So I would want us to take a look at a scripture that is very popular. I believe most Christians know this scripture by heart. And I just want us to revisit it as a reminder, so that this can help us as we focus and go into Christmas. And so I would want us to take a look at John chapter 3 from verse 16. John 3:16, and this is from the New King James Version. It reads, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish but have everlasting life." As we Christians, we know that man erred in the very beginning in the Garden of Eden, and it brought a rift between man and God. And so God did not just forget about us, even because we fell, because we sinned, because man sinned against God. I don't think God forgot about mankind, because he still kept, you know, coming up with ways to redeem mankind, to bring mankind back to himself. So this scripture is the word of God to us that reminds us that he so loved man. He loved man so much. He loved mankind so much. He loved the world, not leaving out anyone, everyone, those who believe, those who don't believe, those who are still to believe. God loves you, and that is why he gave us this great gift to send his one and only Son, perfect Son, Prince of Peace, King of Kings, the one who was, is, and is to come. Yet God sent him into this world to come and live among men, to show the way, and to finally take upon himself all the responsibilities that man had brought upon themselves, the curse, the shame, whatever it was that was a burden on man. The Son of God came so that all of this could change. And God said, you know what, my son, I will send you there to bear all of this upon yourself and take it to the cross so that whoever believes that you did it for them will be saved. So, what a great gift. Come to think of it, as parents, think about how much you love your children. Me, as an example, I don't think I can give up my child for anything. We can even see today some parents, even when their children are the most hardened criminal, you still see the love, you still see how they fight for them, to keep them, not to give them up. And yet God gave his only Son, who was perfect, without sin, who was a king to come and die for a common man like you and myself. What a gift. And today when we celebrate Christmas, over the years, we have deviated from the reason for Christmas. Actually, we do celebrate this day in remembrance of the birth of a king, of the birth of the one who came to take away the sins of the world. So my main message today is just to remind us to remember that Christ came for us, and Christ is the greatest gift that mankind ever had, because he came from heaven, he left his throne, came down just to save you and I, just so that we will be free from the burden of sin, just so that we will be free from the curse of sicknesses, just so that we may be free from pain, just so that our shame may be wiped away. All kinds of things he went through. He lived by example. He showed us the way. And even before he returned, he told us and gave us this promise that he will be with us always, even to the ends of the earth. So that is the greatest gift we can ever have. A friend who sticks closer than a brother. A friend who is always there for you. A friend who is interceding for you, praying for you at all times. A friend whose hands were so stretched on the cross. A friend who, even when condemned by a criminal, turned to the next criminal, who acknowledged him as the Son of God and made a way for him to get into heaven. A king who, while on the cross, saw those who crucified him, saw those who treated him bad. Even when he asked for water, they gave him vinegar. They cursed him out. They did not believe in him. And yet when he died, these same people had the opportunity to make the choice to believe in him and received salvation. And today you and I, we all know what we are going through. We all know how sometimes you will say, I cannot count on man. And yes, the word of God tells us not to lean on our own understanding and not to depend on the arm of flesh. But we thank God that Christ is there, the hope of glory. So we thank God for a great master, a great teacher, a great friend, a great brother, because he says we are joint heirs with him. He is the firstborn. That one that you can turn to at any time, and he will never say, get away from me. As long as we believe in him, as long as you open your heart, you welcome him into your own heart and begin to live according to his ways by his grace. Because he says it's not even by your might nor by your power, but by his spirit. So which means when you open your heart, he gives you that grace to live for him. And so just take a moment today and think about this. God so loved the world. He just did not love the world, but he so loved the world, which means he went to this extent to give us his only begotten Son. That whoever believes in him, whoever believes in the fact that he came to die for you and my sins, will not perish, but will have everlasting life. So I want us to welcome this great gift of God from his throne to us and live for him. And I just pray that as we head into Christmas, we will share this love with someone, because there is someone somewhere who has never heard this message. There is someone somewhere who is struggling through life and don't even understand their purpose, who don't even understand why they had to live, where they came from, where they are going. They are just struggling through life. And no one has ever brought them this truth. But as children of God today, when you hear, share this with someone. Think about it. Think about the love of God. And as you prepare for Christmas, whatever the Holy Spirit lays in your heart, is it about getting a gift for someone who doesn't know Christ yet? And then you attach that message of love to it? Or you show an expression of love in any way that you can do? Inviting them out for dinner, inviting them over for dinner, you know, talking about the love of God, or, you know, expressing it. And I believe when you express it, people will see it and people want to know more about you or what drives you to be that kind of a person. And I believe that's a place where you can help them and lead them to Christ, that they may get to this saving knowledge of Christ and believe and be saved and not perish. I believe if you do this by expressing the love of Christ to someone, you'll bring them to a place where they will believe in Christ and they shall not perish, but they will have everlasting life, just like God has granted it to you and to me. So don't keep his love to yourself. Don't enjoy it to yourself. Don't just think about enjoying the love of Christ here and, you know, having everlasting life after. Think of those who don't know yet about Christ and extend this love to them, because that is our mission on earth. Let's think about the Great Commission before Jesus left. He said we should go into the world and preach the gospel. You start from your Jerusalem and then you move out all the way to the uttermost parts of the earth. I'm talking about your Jerusalem. I'm talking about start from within your house, within your community, and then you go out furthermore to your city and to the uttermost parts of the earth. So I just want to encourage someone today that as we celebrate Christmas, that is coming soon, remember that Christ is the reason for Christmas. And also I pray that you will tell someone about the love of God. Remain blessed, and may the joy of the Lord be yours this season, in Jesus' name. So I just want to call on anyone who does not have a relationship with Christ yet, or who may be wondering what I'm talking about and might not have had the experience of what I'm really talking about. It's not just talk, it's an experience. Christianity is an experience. So, but a lot of times, most people think it's just talk, maybe because of what they have, you know, seen when people talk about Christ, and yet they don't, or heard when people talk about Christ, but they don't see the action. So, but today I'm here to encourage you to open your heart to Christ if you don't yet have a relationship with him, and invite him into your heart and tell him that you would like to experience that life in him. You'd want to invite him into your heart, let him be your king, that you believe that he came into this world to die for you and he rose again and he is now seated in the right hand of God the Father Almighty, interceding for you. If you believe that in your heart and you confess it with your mouth, then you are on a new journey. You are saved and now you are a follower of Christ. And I pray that if you made that prayer, let your life be transformed by the mighty hand of God, that you begin to experience life in a new dimension. This is Kabot Outreach, a ministry where we reach out to our communities and as far as the Holy Spirit would take us. And we usually host a dinner once every month, which is called Holy Ghost Dinner. And for this month, we'll be hosting our dinner on the 15th. The address is on the screen, and that will be in Beltsville, Maryland. So for anyone who lives around the DMV area and you have the time, you can stop by and fellowship with us. It's a great time in the presence of God because, first of all, as our name says it, Kabod, which means we gather under the weight and the heaviness of God's presence. And when we get together and we fellowship, I believe God feeds us and we live strengthened and we are able to take this good news to the ends of the earth. I pray for the peace of God upon your life. And I pray that he will strengthen you and direct your path. I pray for the love of God this Christmas season in your house, in your family, at your job, in all that concerns you. And that whatever you've been struggling with from January till now, December, it's not late, because our God is a God who can suddenly turn things around for you. But one thing you have to do, he says, only believe. And if you pray and you believe, it will be so with you. Thank you so much for watching. Have a very Merry Christmas. God bless you. And hopefully I'll see you again next time. Thank you.